4 days ago, you host a virtual Blox Con. And in that Blox Con, you do all this award giving segments, and you show us a video from Blox Con New York talking about how you're gonna implement your articulated physics, that way you'll be able to build a fucking bulldozer that actually works. Or and they just do some questions and answers. But they fail to mention that they're gonna release a fucking price floor. A price floor that will ruin all clothing on Roblox no matter what. For those who don't know what a price floor is, and I'm sure many of you do not know what it is, I'll explain it to you. I'll make it really easy because the wiki explanation may not get through your head either. Basically, a price floor is you must pay this X amount of whatever currency all the time, no matter what, to get this item. Okay? So if I want to go, I'll give you guys an example. Say a price floor is put in place on candy, and each piece of candy, no matter what, I have to pay 25 cents for. So when I go into the store, no matter what, I have to pay 25 cents all the time. That's what Roblox is doing for clothing. And what they wanted to do is their new great fucking idea that they came out with, probably by the same people who made the pay-to-play access feature. Their idea is to help the economy, get this, to help the economy of Roblox, a fucking building game. They want to put an economy in, they want to help the economy. They want to make it so you have to pay a price floor of 10 Robux or 120 tickets for one t-shirt. Then they want it so you have to pay 25 Robux or 300 tickets for shirts and pants. In order for me to get a full outfit now with this thing, it's like a full outfit, which is basically a one shirt and one pair of pants. In order for me to get that, it's gonna cost me 50 Robux or 600 tickets. And if I want a full outfit with a t-shirt, like say, I have a tie that I bought from the Kestrel store home for 4 Robux, okay? And if I want to wear that tie, or if I want to buy another tie from there, I have to pay, like if I want to buy a whole new outfit and a tie that goes with it, it's gonna cost me 60 Robux or 720 tickets. As opposed to me buying a shirt for 5 tickets and a pair of pants for 5 tickets and a tie for 5 fucking tickets. I can go buy, if this was never here, I could go buy myself a new outfit for 15 tickets. But Roblox, thinking that somehow this will help the economy, puts it so I have to pay 10 Robux for t-shirts, 25 for shirts and pants, 50 for a full outfit, and 60 for an outfit with a t-shirt, which is complete bullshit. And I'm a BC member. This is bullshit. Okay? I only make 15 Robux a day. So that means in order for me to make 60 Robux, I have to wait 4 days just to get enough for 3 items. So how do you think the non-Builders Club members feel? The ones who have been veterans on Roblox and the ones who have had Builders Club or Turbo Builders Club or had OBC, they've had it but it expired. This is how they get fucking repaid. Even though they bought something from Roblox, Roblox doesn't care. They want you to buy more, more, more. And if you want fucking proof of this, the 3 reasons behind them trying to put this in, I'll go get it up for you right now. Roblox blog. And I love how they don't put this in a notification. At least I'm not aware that they put it in a notification. Yeah, there's no notification in my inbox saying we're gonna be putting a price floor down on it. So let me read. These are their 3 exact reasons. One of them I cannot pronounce, and I'll just put intrigue. So, the first reason, raise the quality of items in the catalog. This is their first reason. Reward makers and sellers of clothing, that's number 2, and 3, to intrigue non-paying users to buy Robux. When you see something that says to intrigue users to buy Robux, take out the first two before it and just look at that. You can obviously tell that this is a fucking way to get Robux. And I love how Roblox uses a huge word that 8-year-olds won't be able to understand. It's a word that I cannot even pronounce, so I have to put it under intrigue instead of whatever it is. I'll show it up on the screen. They try and put it at number 3, so it doesn't seem like a big deal, but it should be number 1 because of how fucking horrible this is. And here is my list of reasons on why this update just ultimately sucks dick. Users won't be able to afford any clothing, making the website's slogan useless. Be anything, build anything. I know you have to pay for most of your shit in order to be anything on this website, but Roblox is making it so you can't be anything, period. And if you want to build anything, too fucking bad, somebody's gonna steal it on you. One of the reasons why they did this is to stop copying of shirts, okay? But the thing is, it's going to promote copying instead of stopping it. Because honestly, who the fuck is gonna pay 300 tickets or 25 Robux for a shirt or a pair of pants when they can go take the ID number, minus it by 1, copy the fucking template of it, put it in their paint, transparent everything around it, and have their new set of fucking clothing for free? Okay? People already do this. Making it so you have to, so upping the prices makes a fucking higher black market. I'll let that sink in, okay? Making things worth more doesn't make it so users won't copy it anymore. They're actually gonna copy it more because they can't afford it. Number 3, does not increase the quality of items. Because you put the price of something higher, it's not going to increase the quality of it. If when they did this, they took all the old shirts out there and put them to 300 tickets and 25 Robux. Okay? Now, if any other shirts on the catalog that, like, if there was tons of shirts on the catalog that were shit, and then they did this update, those shitty shirts are still there, okay? You're not going to get rid of them, okay? It's not going to increase quality unless people actually start making new shirts. I myself like to buy from a girl called Shattuck. She makes wonderful clothing. But how am I supposed to afford her stuff anymore? I was okay with 6 Robux or 5 tickets from buying from her. But now, 300 tickets or 25 Robux? How the fuck am I supposed to buy one pair of clothing from her without my fucking wallet getting dented? And this is Roblox's plan to get tons of money off Robux when they have ads and Builders Club, one of the two main things that they can supply. And I'm like sitting here and I'm wondering, why do you need this? Why? What does this do? Okay, so this is the fourth reason. This is in response to one of their reasons on why it should be in there, and it's called rewarding the people who make shirts and clothing. But you know what else it does? It rewards the people who don't deserve tickets and Robux. Do you know how many misleaders and copiers out there have VIPs that are just Google images of VIP put onto it and selling for 10 Robux? And the one thing I noticed as soon as this update came out, guess who are the first people to change their prices on their t-shirts for VIP? The misleaders and the copiers. The first people. So what do they take their 10 Robux and do to it? Make it 50 Robux. Put it back to their original price. That is complete and utter bullshit. But everybody will buy it. So, rewarding the people, yeah, it may reward good people who make clothing, but at the same time, it rewards misleaders and scammers because they'll have to put a minimum of 10 Robux to pay for a VIP for a misleading game. So basically, you're making people lose Robux. Fifth reason, defeats the purpose of getting Builders Club because it will take 4 days for a full outfit. Okay? I already explained this. I can get a full outfit in one day for 15 tickets, but with this new update, it's gonna take me 4 fucking days with Builders Club. Six, I already mentioned this as well. There's no mention of this in the virtual BloxCon, nor did I get a notification, or they didn't even ask for opinions before they released this. Articulated physics? They mentioned it in the virtual BloxCon. This new price floor? They didn't ask for fucking opinions. The only time they ever got opinions was on their blog and on the forums. And the forums are still protesting against this. They've been going fucking 24 hours straight against this because it's complete bullshit. And the last reason is what I just said. They did not ask for feedback, and they just did it, and they w went ahead, and they put this in here. And now they have to reverse all their shit because people are mad. This is from Major Tom 4321, a moderator who posted, "Thanks for the feedback. Hi everyone. Thanks for the feedback on the new pricing feature for clothing." Then he puts the link to it. All of it from the previous thread has been saved and is being reviewed by our team. We know that many of our players had a lot to say on the topic. Gee, you don't fucking say. We're still listening, but please continue to post other appropriate forums for discussion. And let's leave technical and account help for players that need assistance with those issues. Thanks. Major Tom 4321. It took you one fucking day and non-stop forum posts and non-stop blog posts and non-stop videos saying that this new feature sucks dick to get it through your head? And I hope you better reverse this. You better not pull one of those pay-to-play access features and just leave it up there. Because if you leave this up here, you're not gonna help your economy, you're gonna fucking destroy it. If you want to hear my reasoning, why make clothing anymore if nobody can afford it? Most of the people on Roblox are non-Builders Clubs. I'm going to go out on a limb and say that, okay? There's lots of Builders Club members out there, but most of them are non-Builders Club. So, usually, when I joined this website back in 2010 on my old account, I never got Builders Club. At the time, I didn't even know what the chat bar was, put it that way, okay? And I would yell in caps on videos, "How do I get the chat bar?" So, make a 13 plus account, now I got a chat bar. Yay. Anyway, I would have to beg my parents to get Builders Club for me, okay? And the only time I would ever get my Builders Club, my $10 or my $20 Builders Club, would be when I went to the United States, which would require me to go on about a 3-day road trip to Duluth, where I live in Thunder Bay. So Duluth is about 3 days from here if you're taking your time and not just stepping on the pedal. But usually I would go there for the train museum, but one of the main reasons would be GameStop was there, because in Canada they don't have a GameStop. They have EB Games, but I never knew that they had Roblox cards here, and I don't think they even had any. So that was the only time I would ever get my fucking Roblox cards, was when I went to Duluth and I went to GameStop. And that's the only time. And I'd waste 20 bucks, I'd come home, I'd get my my 1,000 Robux and my BC for a month, and I'd be happy as a fucking fiddle. And I think that's saying, I think I said that saying wrong, but I don't care. But one day, I did the same thing. This is our, like, fourth road trip to Duluth, and I do this every time. I enter it, I go to a hotel with Wi-Fi, and I enter in my codes. Me being the stupid little kid I am, I leave my account open, and what do you know? One of the native kids by the casino breaks into my account and wastes all my tickets and Robux and everything and blows all my groups away, and that's how I made Sergeant Bender 2000. But the point about what I just said is, if you are still listening, it takes a while for members to get Builders Club, okay? Same goes for when I started playing TF2. I would have to beg my dad to buy keys for me offline, and trying to get my dad to get credit card or to use his credit card was fucking hard. Now, you expect how many millions of members out there? You have 3 million members. Let's just say that 500,000 of them are active, because I'm going to assume the other 2 million are probably banned and fucking inactive. But out of those 500,000, how many of those do you think are going to be able to get Builders Club like that? And your way of trying to get them to get Builders Club or buy Robux is to increase the prices of your catalog? Here's what that's going to do. It's going to make people not want to buy from the catalog because they can't afford. It's going to take you about 10 days to make up 100 tickets, plus an additional 2 days for the 20 just to get a fucking t-shirt. 12 days for a t-shirt. Or you could save up for 10 Robux. But if you go to the exchange rates, it's going to take you 20 tickets to get 1 Robux, or 18 or 19. I shit you not, that's how they have set it up, okay? You don't get what you pay for anymore. You can't go in there and type in 10 tickets for 1 Robux. Now you gotta type in 20 or 18 tickets for 1 Robux. So, instead of getting 2, I only get 1. So, you just cut what I'm making in half even more, which makes me not want to buy clothing in the long run. 300 tickets? 30 fucking days. I'm gonna save up an entire month to get one shirt. One shirt, people. Not a pair of shirts and pants and t-shirts. One fucking shirt. Then if I want a full outfit, I gotta wait 2 months. And then, if I want to get a new outfit with a t-shirt, basically I'm gonna be paying about 2 months. I can't really do the math right now, I just woke up, but it's 720 tickets, so you do the math. You can understand why most of us are pretty mad and why I'm pretty mad. And before people start calling out saying the only reason you're mad about this is because you're an online dater, I'm not an online dater. Maybe I like to look stylish for once, because I have all these tickets and Robux. Maybe I want to use them for something. But how can I use them when the prices are so fucking outrageous that when I go to buy something, it's going to put a 25 Robux dent? So after buying 4 pairs of shirts and pants, I'm going to lose basically 100 Robux. I only make 450 Robux by the end of my Builders Club, which is 1 month. I'm not going to go out and buy Robux because you want to get Robux. It's called find another way that doesn't ruin your fucking website. One of the main things about your website is your catalog. Even though it's a building game, your catalog makes your game different. But why would you want to turn the thing that makes your website different into an ultimate piece of shit that nobody can afford? Hopefully, and I think they already are doing this, Roblox is going to reverse this. And they aren't going to pull a little pay-to-play feature where they're going to leave it up there for the rest of us to suffer, instead of fixing it, okay? So, Roblox, you better fucking fix this. Otherwise, I'm not going to buy any more clothing. And I've already done that, basically. I've stripped my character down to barely anything. Yes, it may sound weird, but I'm protesting. So if you want to do the same, be my guest. I'm quite mad about this, as you may tell, and I'm sure many others are mad about this. If you go take a kind look at the forums and all things Roblox, you'll see what I mean. And I'm one of the people on there talking about it as well. So expect to see Sergeant Bender 2000 on there a lot more. Thank you for watching, and I hope you support this new protest against the new price feature until Roblox actually gets it to their damn thick skulls that we should not have to pay Robux to buy a piece of fucking clothing.